Okay, this is my 3D printed version 2 tricopter. I've just had it up for the first time since I put the new mid-center body section on, and I've had a chance to look at the onboard footage, and it flew like an absolute pig. Not exactly sure what was going on with it. No idea why it crashed. One of the motor wires on this arm was off, but I don't know if that was because of the crash or actually it caused the crash, so I'm unsure about that. It just totally faded off to one side, and that was it, gone. It dropped to the right, so it would suggest it was that motor. It just did not fly well from the off in this configuration. The only thing, or the main problem that I could see with it, and it was very noticeable this time, and I've mentioned it before, is this tail mechanism. Let's see if I can get it in. And just, it seems to have got progressively worse over the times I've flown it, and there was a lot of movement this time. You could really see it. It's hard to pick up on the video, but it does. It just kind of seems to be making lots of adjustments all the time, and the whole back end was shaking. Like, I thought it was going to shake itself apart this time. I was going to cut my flight short anyway because of the amount of vibration. It was only a matter of time before something shook off, but I ditched it anyway. So that was vibrating. There was a little bit of slop movement in this. I've had this tail mechanism off a couple of times to make some adjustments, but it's my original design, which it works, but I'm not happy with. I know for a fact I can improve this thing, but I've just left it alone because it has been sort of working, is the best description I can say. I've spent more time doing other things rather than playing around with this, but this definitely needs an upgrade at some point, and it will get it. I have managed to reduce the slop in it by a fair amount. I've lifted the servo up a little bit, and I've managed to get the servo pushed more into the direct drive setup that I've got. It's hard to see it on there, but that is a lot more secure, far less slop. The setup, if I get a chance, I am going to redo this back end. This, you can see, it's just sat on top of this 10mm boom. I would prefer, and it does sort of rotate a little bit around it. What I would do next time is kind of put a U shape around this, just to get some bite onto this wooden boom. I'm not sure exactly how yet, but that's the way I'm going to go with this. The actual mechanism is pretty smooth and it's held up. It's just a lot of slop in there, and I think that's causing the oscillations. And I messed around with the settings thinking it could be those. So I played around a little bit with the KK board, and it made no difference whatsoever. I may need to upgrade or do a swap out of this servo, but it all takes time. And I don't think it's that actual servo, so it's a decent servo, that one. Could do with being a bit bigger, but I think it's up to the task. As you can hear in the background, that is version number 3. Currently printing. I'm hoping to get this one done. I'm going away in about 7 days off to the Lake District, so that's the whole point of this one being getting a lot of attention lately. I'm trying to get this one ready to fly over Lake Coniston and Windermere, hence the cheap parts and cheap KK board and cheap orange spectrum, and I'm going to somehow get some buoyancy on my GoPro camera. Because I pretty much suspect this one will end up in Lake Coniston rather than on. You can see I've got a few things going on at the same time with this. I never quite got round to hooking the FPV camera up. It is set on, fixed on, not very well. I'd rather have that lower down. I've dug out an old, I don't even know what this is. As regards what make, I've no idea. I think it's 250mm, I don't know. I've no idea what it is. I'll just be guessing, and I've been looking into which wire does what, because again, I don't have any information on it. so I'm pretty much having to guess. I think I've got the wiring I need, got the power input, and I think that's the signal wire. So that's all I need. I've got it. Oh, where are we? This is the power for the camera, which is going to be sorted out, all ready to go on next time I take this apart, which is going to be very shortly, as soon as I finish printing what I'm printing now. I'm going to assemble all that together. Yellow is the signal. I'm just going to directly solder that to my signal there. The two power ones are going to go onto. I'm going to do get rid of my wiring harness. I'm going to use this distribution board somehow underneath that mount. I'm going to slide it under there, and hopefully it'll line up. I'm pretty sure it lines up. So I'm going to do some soldering tonight, get that set up. So everything's going to run off this distribution board rather than the wiring harness that I've currently got. Just makes it easier for me to wire up all this FPV equipment. That is somehow, if I get a chance, I'm going to maybe just zip tie it. I'm not sure, it depends on time. But that's going to go somewhere on there. Ooh, that way around. Zip tied, or I may 3D print something, which I prefer to do, but I'm not sure I'll get a chance to do it or not. I'm still playing around with, and what I noticed, I showed some onboard footage. It wasn't worth showing much of it because it was very, wasn't really jello. It was, the problem was, this isn't the battery I had a bigger battery than that. And the battery, which is velcroed to the underside deck there, it was actually clashing with this wireframe, if I can see. It was actually touching that, so the wire mount wasn't being very effective. It was kind of catching the vibrations off the battery, if that makes sense. It was all too tight, so and that didn't work, and it didn't help by the fact the tail mechanism was just, it's hard to describe how much it was shaking until you actually see it live. It's absolutely going nuts. So that wired mount wasn't really a good test for it. I'm going to put it up again tomorrow in this configuration, I think, just to test, and with this smaller battery on, which is there's a slight gap between the battery and the wired mount. So I'm going to use that configuration and hopefully just get a test of this wired mount. And I know that has been adjusted, and hopefully that tail mechanism will be a lot better. I've definitely firmed it up. I've glued it a little bit as well, just to stop it moving around. I've lifted it up a millimeter with a bit of packing, and zip tied it a lot better. So I'm hoping that will create a lot more stable tail. If not, it's going to be something to do with either the servo or the settings. So that's its current shape and status. The one I'm printing off, which is there, there's quite a few modifications on this next version 3. I could do with seeing whether this wired mount works or not. That's the downside, but I'm printing in this new one off anyway, the view that the wired mount does work and will work. So next version will be with FPV kit and a new GoPro mount of some description, which is winging its way off the 3D printer in the next couple of hours or so. Right, so somewhere amongst this lot there is a tricopter, believe it or not, a version 3 with a new camera mount. I've tried to work with my version 2 there, and I just cannot get that tail mechanism sorted out. It just, I don't know, I think it's something to do with the frequency of it. It's just matching that of the whole tricopter, and it is shaking around like crazy, which means the camera mount, which I think would work. I think this wired camera mount would normally work if it wasn't for the fact this was just vibrating like absolutely. It looks, really does look as though it's going to shake itself apart. That's how bad it is on the camera. It doesn't really show up. But I've got a couple of plans. I've played around with the KK board. I've messed around with the settings on this. I'm sort of happy with the settings I've got, and it's still no different. I can go up and down the pin IDs. Just alter them, it makes no difference whatsoever on the old tail mech vibrating. So, on here, there is a new version about to be born. First thing I'm going to do, and where is it? There we go. Is I'm going to go with a carbon fibre tailpiece. I'm just going to do the tailpiece up only due to the time constraints that I've got. So fortunately that's a 10mm carbon rod, and I'm going to go with this just for a quick fix and stiffen it up, and hopefully it will remove a lot of the frequency vibrations, oscillations, call them what you will. I'm hoping this will be a good fix. Second plan is, where is it? I've got another motor, another Gowie motor that I had laying around, and I'm thinking it could well possibly be a bent shaft on that one. These are off ones that have been old Gowie 500 quadcopter, which had been crashed, and I've got some bent ones, shafted ones somewhere. Most of them are okay, and to be honest, the one that's actually on there, it feels pretty smooth, so I don't think it's that, but I'm going to try and eliminate it with this new one, or replacement one. It feels quite smooth, so I'm going to swap that out and put that in. That's my second thing, and then the third, where is it? Let me have a go. This is the, again, the yaw mechanism. I've updated this 3D printed part just to remove, when I first made it, it was really a rush job just to make a tricopter, so the tail mechanism really was a bit rough. So I've gone and used what I know from the first version, and I've integrated it into this one, and I've made it so hopefully there'll be less movement in it. Now there was a bit of slop in the previous version, but this one hopefully will remove all the slop, and I've also lowered the tolerances on everything, so it's all going to be pretty tight to start with. I did notice that when I first flew this tricopter, the whole mechanism at the back was pretty tight, but over time it's just become loose. It hasn't had that many flights, and has become loose. I think the servo is okay. I think that's man enough for the job. It is a metal geared high speed servo. It's not a top end one, but it is decent enough for this. Eventually, if I can get this working properly, I will put a upgraded one on, a really decent one on there. And hopefully that will also help. What else have I got on? Oh, the tail mechanism as well. As you can see on there, it is just zip tied, and it is held on by a bit of double-sided tape as well. On this second version, I am going to use, I'm going to clamp it, so that is going to, where's my tube there, that is going to sit on the carbon tube, and then underneath, let me have a look, that is going to sit on like that, and I am going to use double-sided tape again, and then I'm going to clamp those two pieces together, just so there's no torsion on it. On this one I can flex it a fair bit. You can see that's more or less what's happening. The whole tail end is shaking like this all the time. And hopefully the front arms are fine. It's just the tail is doing this. And like I said, I think it's a frequency oscillator. You can shake it very easily. So I'm hoping this new version sitting on there somewhere will provide a more stable platform. I need to rush because I've only got a couple of days, so tonight I'm going to do a bit of soldering, get it all together. I'm going to use a distribution board, which is somewhere there, over there, and I've got, my camera is already glued on, I've got these, which came today, and I might put one of these on. It's a 250 milliwatt fat shaft video transmitter. I may use that, undecided on that, because I've got this old beaten up one over here, so I'll probably use this first of all. We'll see how it goes. Probably use that because it is meant to be a cheap kind of tricopter. And I've got delivered a load of these button head bolts, which should hopefully countersink in this new plate, which I've got set up, so they should kind of sink it in there nicely and make it a lot tidier. Those are going to be for my new camera mount, which is based on the RC Explorer one, which uses a plate of sorts. Sort that out, which will take the battery loading and then your GoPro up front. I might change this because I want the proper GoPro interface on there. I did this just as a rush, so I need to print maybe another one of these off once I've done a quick test, hopefully get it tested in the air tomorrow. So that's about it. One tricopter, version 3 coming soon, or possibly version 4 coming very shortly after that one. So let's see how it goes, and hopefully I can get this thing sorted out in time for going away.